lived in Canada. We lived in North Bay, Canada. It is, I recall, about 300 or 400 miles north of Niagara Falls on the Canadian side. And my dad was putting in the Bomark missiles. They're above ground missiles that set inside, look like big pole barns. And he was up there installing the Bomark missiles in Canada. And we lived in a trailer park with 12 trailers. And it was a Boeing trailer park that he took and built it specifically for the Boeing employees that were putting in the missile. And there was a chain link fence around the actual missile site. But it wasn't for people, it was for animals, so to keep the animals out. It was about 1 foot square holes in the fence. And during the day, they had a guard posted up high so that if he saw a grizzly bear, they would set off an alarm so that people knew in the trailer park to keep their kids home or keep them close. And so every once in a while, you hear that alarm go off and everybody had to go back in the trailer and stay in there until the all clear was sounded. We lived right off of a Canadian pipeline. And so if you walked out of the trailer and you went back what seems like a quarter of a mile to me now, I don't really know, you'd come to the end of the Boeing fence, and it ended right on that pipeline. And that pipeline was a cleared piece of land right through the middle of Canada, about 50 yards wide. Half the width of the football field probably, and it was just right down to the dirt. I mean, you had stumps and stuff, but it was cleared so they could run machinery through and dig a trench to lay this. And I don't think it was an oil pipeline, I think it was a gas pipeline. But anyway, we used to walk up to that pipeline at the corner of the fence, and then we'd take a right and go follow that pipeline clear cut back up a ways. And there was some lakes up there that had blind fish. There were white fish and they had no eyes. They just had little dark dots where eyes would normally be. That whole area was frozen tundra type of land where during the summer it would thaw out the first foot or so and it would be very marshy and you'd have tons and tons of bugs. And if you dug down, you dig down into permafrost. It was just frozen all year. Never thawed. The water would increase in the lakes because of the thaw. That's about the only thing. And then it didn't go anywhere, obviously, because the ground was frozen. Wouldn't let the water, just kept on the surface. She had a lot of problems with biting black flies and mosquitoes and stuff like that. But anyway, we used to walk up to that pipeline and walk down that pipeline to that lake and try to catch or shoot those white fish. And when I say shoot, I mean we had bows with arrows. We were trying to bow hunt the fish, and we never got a single fish. And I don't know, I was in the fourth grade, I believe. Well, one day we walked up there, and I went with Larry, so older boy who lived in the trailer park, and we walked up to that pipeline and took the right and walked down this big deep hill and then back up the other side to where the lake was, and he had a bow and he was trying to shoot the fish. He got tired of shooting at the fish, and I can't remember if I had a BB gun with me or not, but we turned around to come back and we could see in the distance up near where the Boeing fence was that there was an animal there. And we first were afraid it was a wolf because we were both scared of wolves and there was a lot of timber wolves up there. So we kept walking because that's the only way to get back to the trailer park. You can't cut through the woods. The woods were so deep and so thick that our chances of getting through the woods that way were just about impossible. And so we kept walking. As we got closer, it got bigger. We thought, well, we're okay. It's not a wolf. That was our big fear. Well, as we got closer, it got bigger, and I thought, well, it's a deer. And then as we got closer, we realized it was too big for a deer. And that's when we realized it was a moose. It was a big moose. So we stood there for a minute, and the moose went into the woods. We thought, well, we better get up there and see if we can get up there and get down before that moose comes back. So we got up to almost the corner where the fence line was, and the moose came out of the woods at us and was running. And we both took a run at that fence, and I actually dove through one of those 1 foot square fence holes. And that moose was right up on us, and there's a stanchion there where you take and you can put a big wheel on there, I guess, and turn off the gas valve or something. It's a probably a 3 foot square, maybe 4 foot square, sit about 2.5 feet, 3 feet off the ground, and in there was where you would turn that valve. Well, what we did was we got up to that corner of the bowling fence, and then we walked down the fence line back towards the trailer park. So we needed to go that way. And so when the moose chased us into the fence, you know, it terrified both of us, but we both realized we were safe because we were on the other side of the fence. Then we thought we're in trouble because we're on the inside of the fence, and our dad said we'd get in real big trouble if we were ever in there. So we didn't have much time to ponder that, and the moose walked back into the woods. And we thought about, should we walk down the fence line on the inside where we're not supposed to be? And we've had fears like, is there a guard in there? They're going to shoot us and that kind of stuff. We didn't really know that much about it. And the stuff was all secret, so, you know, the parents didn't really talk that much about it either. About then, we heard my dad holler for us. I hollered to him. I said, Dad, did you bring your gun? He says, yeah. I says, which gun? Well, the .22. I'm going, oh, gosh. He brought a .22. He says, Dad, you got to stay there. There's a moose up here. And he's busy hollering at us and cussing us out because we're on the inside of that fence. And we're trying to tell him what had happened, and he wasn't listening to us. And he got almost up to where that stanchion is, and we're on one side of the fence, and he's on the other. And he's just madder can be. And out of the woods comes this moose. Suddenly, my dad changed. Well, he didn't think about aiming that gun at that moose. That moose was gigantic. You think your moose down here are big. You should see one of the Canadian or Alaskan moose. Oh, they are so big. This moose proceeded to charge my dad. My dad was too big to make it through a 1 foot square hole. And so he got on the other side of the stanchion. And the moose and my dad played ring around the rosy, around the stanchion. And you know what moose do is they stomp on you if they can get close enough to you. They don't bite you. And I mean, if they feel it was a, you know, if it had a huge rack or something like that, it would probably maybe gore you. But so here's my dad ducking and weaving around this thing, trying to keep the moose from getting him. And finally, the moose kind of got tired and just stomped off back into the woods. My dad says, let's get the hell out of here, you know. So we climbed back through that fence and all took off and went down there. And I guess my dad told somebody about it, and it was a hazard, a danger, whatever. Anyway, they, a bunch of men loaded up the next day into one of these cats that can go across the snow and everything else. There was no snow at the time. It was just mud. But they went back up in there, and they shot that moose. They brought it back down, and it was 9 foot tall with the shoulder blades. And it was just a massive moose, probably weighed 2,000 pounds. It's just gigantic. Anyway, that was the end of that moose story, but we did have moose coming in and eating into the garbage cans on a regular basis there. And none of them were ever violent with anybody, and everybody's always careful not to go out there and cross them. I don't know why that particular moose was that way. We've always thought about whether it had young, and I don't know that much about when they, you know, drop calves and when they do that kind of stuff, or what was the problem with that particular moose. It ended up being moose burgers, so. And we were forgiven for going through the fence. That was good.